Hey gang, what's going on? How y'all doing? What's up? Wow. What's up, Spice? What's up, Dom? Two Hit, Manic, Silver Mike, RV Winkle, Worst Elephant, Eva, Satellite. Hi everybody. Happy Friday. I hope you're doing well. I bet you are. I bet you're doing real good, because it's Friday. The week is almost over. We're on to the fun part now. We're on to the weekend. I'm very excited about that. What's up, Fury? Good to see you. I saw y'all speculating on what tonight is about, and I just saw Oddish has information that will lead to the arrest of Hillary Clinton. I started laughing so hard. I'm glad my mic was muted. Also, Dominic noticed me being sneaky and moving around windows. I'm usually pretty good on nights where I don't already have a game up to be doing stuff over on the other monitor, but I need a spreadsheet. You can't do a proper announcement without a spreadsheet. And it was a little unwieldy and kind of peeked over, so. Most obvious thing to me is what's coming up in the coming months. It's the announcement of sponsorship for Raid Shadow Legends. You know, I just have to assume at this point that my invitation got lost in the mail. I had the mail around here lost a jury duty summons of mine. The original summons never showed up anywhere. And then the notification of missing my jury duty went to my old house. So, unfortunately, they were nice enough to pass it along to me. So, I'm sure that's what happened to my Raid Shadow Legends big money sponsorship deal. Yeah, that was concerning when I realized that was a thing that could happen, because I could have gotten in a lot of trouble for that. Did just proper announce without a spreadsheet. Nerd alert! Newhauser, come on. You've been here long enough, you know. You know how I do. Surprised you didn't get a Thymesia invite? I get a lot of PR emails. And I don't reply to most of them anymore. I used to be a lot more active, like courting indie developers and hunting down new games that were coming out and asking for review copies and stuff. That was years ago when I was less clear on what I wanted to be doing on my streams and for reviews. These days, I just kind of let a lot of that stuff slide by unless it's something that I'm personally very invested in. Shoot for a Genshin or G Fuel sponsorship instead. Genshin could be fun. I've always meant to try Genshin and never got around to it. Oh shit, I left my window open. Hang on a sec, chat. I don't actually know how far my voice carries in the neighborhood, but I mean, like, why risk it, right? The news is you're going to jail. Why would that be news? Why would I announce that? Why wouldn't I just vanish from the face of the earth if that was the case? Announcement is Oddish is entering into a sponsorship deal with Fortnite, and this is now a Fortnite channel. Wouldn't that be something? That would be an incredible turn. I would only do that if they put me in Fortnite. So I could throw Kamehamehas at Darth Vader and Thanos. I would totally become the Fortnite channel for that. That'd be fuckin' rad. That was the announcement Oddish left. That was it. We're just gonna play Playdate and Playdate games and ROM hacks for the rest of the evening. That was it. Thanks for coming to my TED Talk, everybody. No, don't. Now he's got a shill for the Epic Games Store. It's about 2 months away from a known event. Mm-hmm. Seriously, if you're sent to jail, does anyone in your family have your passwords to notify important people? I always worry about that for my passwords. I think I mentioned to my wife one day that I needed to give her all my login information so she could let y'all know if something happened to me, and then I never followed up on that. So I'm still banking on immortality here at the moment. But Genshin added a big new area, which wouldn't be super relevant for you if you just started playing because there's three areas before it. You worry about being sent to jail? Psh, no. What would I be sent to jail for? My criminal good looks? My charm that should be illegal. The new area is also really pretty at night. Come on. We would all worry about you terribly if you just vanished off the face of the earth. That's... Manix got it. That's my announcement tonight. I'm not going back to jail. Nintendo Power Piracy. Doping for shooter competitions. Y'all are getting really good at this. I'm starting to worry that my announcement is going to disappoint in the face of all these amazing possibilities. Oh my god. I'm taking the entire Twitch chat hostage, hence the just talking. but I'm not even doing just talking. I decided to keep it retro. It totally is going to disappoint. My brain was like, I'm moving to Japan to teach again. I'm disappointed already. What's up, Spooky? No, it's, I need to kill some time before I do it, because the way the metrics on my channel work, like, lots of people filter in over the first out. Wow, actually, a lot of people are here already. So I guess I don't need to kill too much time. Hello, Nemrin. Good to see you. Freeform tags they have now just mess with me. I don't even mess with tags anymore. I was like, I saw that they did that. I saw that you could just tag your channel as anything. And I was like, huh, I wonder if this is relevant. And I went and I clicked around like some big channels and some small channels. And everything was the same. And a few of them had some weird tags. And I was like, okay, whatever. What's up, Krager? Do I have 5 minutes to get a snack? Yes. Okay. Chat, start your watches. We have to kill 5 minutes. Okay, we can't start until Krager comes back. You said something worrying, so we all showed up. Is it really so worrying if I have an announcement? Like, wouldn't I have been much more dour the last couple of nights? Wouldn't I not be hyping up an announcement if it was something bad? If it was like, I'm quitting streaming, bye everybody. Come on now. Can you wait till I pee? That, yeah, please inform us of your urinary habits, Fury Fighter, so I'll know when to pick things back up. Yes. Oh my god. No, that's the announcement, chat. I'm only reviewing porn games now. I can't stream on Twitch anymore. It's too hot. It's a Mountain Dew bottle, jeez. You'd be hyped for our disappointment and our horror. That's true. Have an announcement, Shake said. He's not quitting, he's going down to one night a week. That would be quitting for me. That would be the quitter's path. I stream too much to like cut down at all, really. It would feel weird. Like, it honestly, streaming 6 nights a week. Like, Sunday is Sunday. Like, Sunday is, like, my one night to decompress and hang out with my family and play whatever I want and stuff. That's normal. If I miss another night somewhere, it feels so weird. If I'm, like, sick or there's some emergency or something, or, like, if I go out with friends or something, like, it feels so weird not to stream. I'm so used to it. Because, I mean, think about it. I do what? I do what? Like 300 streams a year doing this? Right? Is my math correct? Roughly-ish? Dreamworld Coke was the worst thing I've ever drank. Not only streaming horror and XCOM games. I'm now considering XCOM games horror games and only streaming XCOM games. About 313, a little more. Okay. Whew. Y'all, I'm not here for math. Math is not my strong suit here. Doing hentai games, not a whole lot of competition there. I see some room to move in the niche. I have actually considered doing like porn game reviews because I noticed nobody does it. But then I also have to second guess myself. I'm like, well, why does nobody do it? And I inevitably come to the conclusion that people buy porn games don't actually care about the quality of them. Which isn't really that much of a surprise. Oz is your intervention. You have streamitis, and we're all concerned you have a problem you're not willing to admit. So I'm announcing my own intervention. That's kind of interesting. Some of them are even good. Not a surprise, Frog for Action stream. No, I'm afraid not. Nobody wants to admit playing porn games. That's the other thing, too. I'd have to set up a whole separate persona. And then when I wrote reviews, I would have to change my style enough so that there's not that much commonality between them. Okay, right in when Osh starts talking about porn. Emerald! What timing! What incredible comedic timing you have. You see something awful, pay for front page reviews. I actually applied to that. I actually communicated with them about that and I never heard back, so. Eh. That was not the only paid gig I've looked into before. I have found other folks advertising on Twitter for paid like website content and stuff, and I've put out feelers, not the porny kind, but like, you know, contacting people and seeing, and nothing ever panned out, so it's fine. I would much rather spend my time streaming. Lula 3D exists, and that game is the worst quality game I've ever played. No one else feels like intervening, so it's up to you. Probably more they pay for a specific kind of quality isn't exactly the one you'd be evaluating. That's also true. You're moving exclusively to streaming Slenderman and Five Nights at Freddy's games? Oof. 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 Entire reviews can be a reasonable length. Using Terra's Trigger to play Haunting Ground, we can get to work. Yeah, Haunting Ground, I've watched. Haunting Ground is the one with the girl and the dog. And the really creepy enemies and storyline, right? Where she's being stalked by a different super fucked up person in each area. If that's the one I'm thinking of, I've watched an LP of that, and it was, it sure was something. Good to go? Okay, Cragger's back. We can proceed. He's gonna be wearing a Groucho mask on all streams now. That's the announcement. So waiting for Otis to take off the mask and show us who he really is. Scooby-Doo style. Old man Smithers! And I would've gotten away with it too, if you weren't for you meddling chatters. The Japanese version of Haunting Ground is worse. Yeah, Emerald, I know. I remember from the Let's Play I watched that it was really messed up. Especially the first guy. First guy really sets the tone for the game. Alright, well, I guess we could do this thing, huh? I guess I have an announcement, and I guess I better make it, so. I don't think, just to preface this, just to set some expectations, I don't think anybody's gonna be shocked by this. I don't think it's gonna come as a big surprise to anybody. In fact, I think once I start prefacing this, some of you are gonna be like, oh, it's this. But, it is an important topic, it is an important decision, and we're gonna have a lot to talk about thereafter. So. It's nice meeting everyone before Audit disappears forever. Oh yeah, Ricard, yeah. They're all the worst in their own ways, really. I was running for Congress, yay! No, I don't think I could handle that. So anyway, just tell us where you put the antidote. Alright, chat, let's do this. Let's talk about this. So, some of you who read my prose, who visit my website, might remember that back in December of last year, I was due like a recap on the gold-plated games anniversary, which is December 27th. I talk about where we've been, how we got here, what we're doing now, and what I hope to do in the future, that sort of thing. As you may remember, December's a big ask. Well, I did think to actually bring it up here so I can show you what I'm talking about. I feel unexpectedly bad. Your reviews are not too high. Some of them are. Some of them are. If you've never read my Ghost Ship Aftermath review, that one is too long. That one is absolutely too long. I need to revise that bastard sometime. Scam writing pros and cons. Yeah, I did. I'm not going to show you, but I have notes. I have notes over here on the other monitor. So if you see my eyeballs going over here, I'm checking my cue cards for stuff. Is that your announcement that you plan ahead now? Yep. New Oh God, Newhauser. I hate to admit it, but I started this in like 2016, I guess. Because Goldplated Games is 6 years old. The whole Goldplated Games concept is 6 years old now, so. So anyway, yeah, I put up a post about what we've been doing. Yeah, only 10 years late. Yeah, Finger on the pulse. That's why this is such a successful channel. So yeah, talking about, I was on hiatus for like a year. I came back and did that stuff and what I was focusing on and stuff. Okay. This right here is what I want to talk about. So back in December, I said that one of my big goals for the year, for 2022, had to do with the question of specialization. I had been thinking for a long time that it might be a good idea to focus this channel a bit more because I've been doing wide open variety the whole time I've been streaming. I started out playing the stuff that I was reviewing when I first started streaming 4 years ago. At that time I was playing like Graveyard Keeper and like all kinds of indie horror stuff and things like that. And this channel's done fine. I mean, obviously, all of y'all are here. There's new faces showing up all the time. Well, faces. There's new folks showing up all the time. But since I started, I had spread out to retro stuff. I was playing new games. I was playing major releases. Hey, I have a face. Wanted to like Graveyard Keeper so much. I might go back to that sometime. I keep thinking about playing that sometime when I'm in the mood to manage things. Anyway, damn it, chat, you're distracting me. So, in 2021, we reached a place where I was pretty much spending half of my time doing like indie or big games, like the like full playthroughs. And I was spending half of my time doing retro stuff on the Power Hours and then like ROM hacks or full playthroughs of stuff or stuff like that. So I was thinking at the beginning of this year, do I need to specialize? Do I want to specialize? Is this something I even need to do? Because I've always been happy with this channel. I've always been happy with the way we've done things. I've always been happy to sit down and play things with y'all and get feedback on y'all from y'all on what we should be playing and what we should be doing and how we should be doing it and stuff like that. But the fact of the matter is, for a channel this size, it seems like in general, you benefit a lot more the more you specialize because it helps set expectations. It helps keep people coming back to the channel once they discover it. Because I always think of it like, I think of this as like a TV show. There is the Audis show, 6 nights a week, 9 p.m. Pacific, every night except Sunday, and people tune into the Audis show. And if you're tuning into a show and it is like wildly different, like completely different every single night, you're probably not gonna watch it. Like you're gonna find it. You're gonna watch the parts that are interesting to you and then skip out. I'm going to Genshin to Fortnite. It sure seems that way, doesn't it? That's just a consequence of the way Twitch operates. You know, the really popular stuff on Twitch, the most popular stuff on Twitch, I mean, everybody knows, is, well, just chatting channels, but also competitive multiplayer. Because competitive multiplayer hits this like perfect note where you are doing, you're playing the same game every day. It's the same game, the same content, but there's the random factors of who you're competing against and what happens in the match and who you might be teamed up with and all of that. So it's perfect for the Twitch format and the expectations on this platform. Roguelikes similarly do really well because it's the same game over and over again, but each run is specifically randomized, right? Stuff like full playthroughs have traditionally been kind of hard sells on Twitch. And I can tell you from my own metrics, which I measure obsessively because I love metrics, that there is a very, very specific arc to full playthroughs that almost, but not always, mostly always happen. Mostly always happen. Where the first night is your peak. Because that's when people are tuning in to see what's going on and what you're doing and what's this game and oh, that's cool and whatever. And then it just drops off after that and levels off usually at a much lower level for the rest of the playthrough. Because a lot of people that show up on that first night, they've seen it, they're good with it, they don't need to see anymore, or they've seen it. And this is particularly pertinent to my channel. People see something and they're like, oh shit, I want to play that. And then they won't come back for the rest of the playthrough. And I understand that because it's always been like one of the big bits of utility I feel like this channel has provided is being able to show off new stuff. Like I've all like, especially on the old Friday variety nights when I would do lots of indie games and stuff. You know, being able to do a lot of first looks of stuff that people are curious about. So that's, I understand the appeal of that and also why people won't tune in if we keep doing that stuff, so. Most popular stuff, there's a variety of people who have been streaming. Yes, that's the thing. Variety works for established streamers. Variety works for the streamers who've already come up doing something else and now they have an established viewer base that will watch them do literally anything and they can play whatever the hell they want. The oddest show stays on the air due to nepotism. Time for puppets. Just beginning to see the fuss and be honest, I'm not into following the biggest thing. As long as I care about a game, I'll watch regardless. Yeah, and Beth, that's very true. And I think that's where most of my current audience comes from, is people who are into that kind of variety and seeing different things. There is definitely an audience for that on Twitch. Like there's, you know, variety is not a dirty word on this platform. Lots of channels do fine doing variety. It's just, if you're talking about growth, if you're talking about growing a channel, it's pretty much been proven that specialization is what grows a channel. And then once a channel reaches like a critical mass, at that point, it almost doesn't matter what the streamer is streaming anymore because people are showing up for them. And more them and less the game itself, so. Barbara's was talking about this earlier this week. Those conclusions was do what you want and worry about the rest later. We're getting to that. If I have to miss a night of a full playthrough, I have to make a call if it's worth fitting in the VOD or just having a gap. Yes, that is another thing. I'm glad you mentioned that, Satellite, because that is another problem with full playthroughs, is that especially with story-driven stuff, like RPGs, adventures, you're gonna lose people who miss a night or two and then just decide, well, I don't want to have the rest of the story spoiled if I haven't filled in the middle part, you know? They might have been really invested in. They might have been really enjoying a full playthrough, but they missed a couple nights. They don't have time to catch up on the VODs. They don't want to jump ahead in the story. So there he goes. How's Oddish ever gonna make partner reviews? Popular enough! Speedrunning is a good way to get views too, especially for the top percent. I will tell you right now, I do not have the patience to be a speedrunner. I envy speedrunners. I envy anybody who can sit there and play the same game for like 1,000 hours. I can't even conceive of that. I am far too moody a gamer for that. And that's another thing. That's another thing. That's factored into this calculus of specialization is I am moody. I cannot sit here and play the same game for. There are games that I absolutely love. There are, and there are games with endless content, like builder games and roguelikes and management sims and even some multiplayer games, maybe, I guess, that I do absolutely love, but I get so sick. I get so sick of even stuff that I love. He says before going back to his, that's different. That's busy work. That's chore. I'm not really playing a game there. I'm just pushing buttons so I feel like I have something to do on my phone because nobody ever calls me. Is the announcement that you're entering into 2008 and getting a YouTube channel when you're going to post playthroughs? Yes, I have discovered time travel. I'm going to go back to the Justin TV days and I'm gonna start there. And I'm gonna be a huge successful streamer. That's the plan. Neuhauser figured it out. Hate having to watch VODs, I like things live. I know what you mean. If you decide to drop Retro before playing Ocarina of Time, I'll find you and I'll force you to play it on stream. This is amazing. It's really interesting to see where where chat is going with this, just the way I'm talking about it. I guess it's the tone and the examples that I'm using here that are causing y'all to make assumptions. So the mayor calls me same, very, very same. You have an extra seat in your time. I would stuff all y'all in there if I could to go back to a better time. Just specialize in boomer shooters. All right, so let's get to this then. Let's get to the meat of this. The truth is, here's the thing. When I was considering specialization, when I made this post here, there were basically two options because I have always focused on two things, indie games and retro games. And that was the decision that I was trying to make. Or if I was going to make a decision at all. Do I specialize in indie games? Do I specialize in retro games? Because I love them both. This is another thing I want you all to understand. I will never specialize in something I don't enjoy because that will make me hate streaming. And I'm not going to do that. This is like... This right here is so important to my mental health. You do not understand. Like, this is such a... God, sorry, I didn't mean to bump the desk like that. Streaming is such an important part of my day now. And I will never do anything to jeopardize the enjoyment and relaxation and just mental health that I derive from this. So, and yes, I know it's important to a lot of y'all as well. And I certainly don't want to do anything to spoil that, certainly. Thought I'd add my two cents. I'm doing the things. I'll keep you in mind, of course, only do what you like. Of course. If you dual class, you have to get the level you're at before you get new content. So, the big question for me is, do I specialize in indie games or do I specialize in retro games, right? The truth is, the truth is, by February of this year, I had actually already figured it out. I had already come to a very quiet personal decision on this. One that I wasn't going to announce. Because I realized what it was that I really enjoyed doing, and I realized what it was that people really enjoyed seeing. And so I kind of made a decision for myself of how I was gonna specialize. However, I was thrown off by a couple things. One was several new games that came out that I was really, really interested in. The new Lego Star Wars, the new Kirby game, the new King of Fighters. I wanted to stream all of those. And I'm sure I don't need to remind y'all, I did a full playthrough of the new Kirby game, and it was the metrics-wise. I loved playing that game. The people that showed up for it loved it. Metrics-wise, that was the worst thing I did all year. My numbers just went after that. So I was like, okay, this was fun, but it wasn't fun enough to sabotage my channel by doing more stuff like this. So, which is fine because it was a new AAA game. It wasn't one of the two paths that I was considering at the time. I was also, I also decided to play some stuff like Astalon, and like, Well, we can go through that later. We can talk about the things that really factored into this decision. So, so I kind of had made like a quiet decision to myself in February, but I wasn't really sticking to it. It was not until XCOM Apocalypse that it really clicked in, that I really realized what it was that I wanted to be doing. XCOM Apocalypse was the true awakening moment for this, because it was probably one of, if not the most fun thing I've streamed, like ever. I had such a good time playing through that game, despite its flaws, despite how frustrated I got with it at the end. I wanted to kill y'all. It was the total package. It was everything I could have asked for. So that was when I really, and on top of that, it was also the most popular thing I've ever streamed. So that, combined with the decision I made in February, led me to the true decision. What I'm announcing to you now is that yes, I have decided to officially focus this channel on retro stuff. Specifically, not just retro. I'm actually gonna go a little bit narrower than that. I'm going to focus on weird old games. That is the announcement. I'm not rebranding, but I'm refocusing to weird old games. We can still do indie stuff too sometimes, right? As a treat. Okay, so y'all are so funny. Let's talk about what this actually means. Okay, because I see a lot of hmms. I see a lot of speculation. What's up, Del Polo? I knew the moment I said this, people are gonna be like, does X count? Does Y count? Does A count? Does B count? Hang on a second. First and foremost, I'm gonna make myself huge so you can focus fully on what I'm saying here, okay? Yeah, of course you count. Of course you count, Spice. Here's the deal. First and foremost, most importantly, this is not a rule, okay? I'm not saying anything you can do yourself. This is not, we are only doing weird old games, and here is how I define weird, and here is how I define old, and we will only play these games, and nothing else will ever show up on the show. That is not what I'm doing. This is a direction, all right? I have decided on a direction. This is what I want to focus on. It is not what I'm gonna do exclusively. So, what does that mean for what we're doing right now? All right. The Power Hours. The Power Hours is fine. The Power Hours is safe. The Power Hours is one of the reasons I came to this conclusion, actually. Because, think about it. The most fun we ever have on the Power Hours is when we're playing weird old stuff. Like Bioforce Ape, and those weird submarine games on the Game Boy, and Monster in My Pocket, and Faria. Like, the Power Hours really embodies like what it is that I like, or Boggle, what I really like about this direction. It's the key here is discovery. What exactly, Manic? You're pretty much a retro channel already. That's what I decided back in February. I decided, okay, I'm gonna go retro. And I started focusing more of my playthroughs on, I mean, here, I'm gonna get out the spreadsheet since y'all can't see my main screen now, and I can hide this from you. Ha 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 ha. My metrics, not yours. Yeah, back in February, I came to this realization, right? And part of that realization came from, I mean, back in December, we played System Shock 2. Y'all had me play Gothic. Y'all really, really like that stuff. From January into February was Bloodborne. There was a lot of Bloodborne. But then in February, I had an incredibly popular night on Valentine's when I played Mega Man 3. We started playing the Chizo Mythos, which are also weird old games. We started playing the Elite Force games, the Star Trek shooters. All this stuff did really well. And then between that, I played the Kirby game, and that went nowhere, really. I played Thief 2. I played a bunch of Game Boy games and stuff. I mentioned Astalon earlier. So after deciding internally that I was going to do retro stuff, right? I had given big name games a chance, right? I figured I'll give indie stuff a chance too. Astalon was a lot of fun. Astalon did not do very well, honestly. Retro-esque enough to count. I think maybe I should explain why retro is so popular around here, because I think there's a specific reason for it. It's not the style, per se. It's not retro games themselves. I think part of the appeal of retro stuff is that they're usually games that people would otherwise not play. And I feel like a lot of this stuff really embodies that. XCOM Apocalypse, Syndicate. I don't think any of y'all are going to go back to Syndicate on your own, right? The Thief games, the Elite Force games. Those retro games they're still available, but they're from a different era. They're not as accessible to get into as more modern retro-themed games like Astalon are. So I'm much, much less likely to do a full playthrough of something that's actually retro, that's actually from, like, you know, 20, 25 years ago. People are more likely to stick around for that full playthrough than they are for a modern game that's retro-styled like Astalon. I think Astalon suffered because I played it the first night for Community Night, and people were like, holy shit, this is really cool, and then folks checked out to actually play it themselves, which they should do, because it's a really good game. Partly because we're mostly old and desperately clinging to our shattered memories. Hi, Vesty, what's going on? What's up? I've decided to specialize the channel. We're going to focus on weird old retro games. Weird old plated games. We're doing retro and weird. When can we expect Steel Battalion? Do we need a donation? We would need a donation drive for that, definitely. That's hard to get a hold of. Thief, I'll play again for sure. Yeah, but like, people aren't exactly worrying about spoilers for that, you know? Spoilers are kind of a thing, you know? Spoilers are a thing that concern a lot of folks. They might not concern you specifically, but I think there are plenty of folks floating around on Twitch who are like, ooh, I'm interested in this game. Let me watch a bit of it. If it looks cool, I'm going to go play it. And I think there's just this thing where, like, people don't really worry so much about spoilers for retro games because they've existed for decades. I was turning heel saying chat stings too much. Retro games just have an energy to them you don't get from modern games. That's another thing, too. Yeah, I see a couple of you saying that. More open to communal experience somewhere. So I'm going to go back to what I was saying about discovery. I've come to realize that I think my favorite thing about streaming is the process of discovery. Either me discovering a game that I never knew anything about, that some new and unique experience, or the discovery that all of you experience when I play something that you've never really been familiar with. And I feel like XCOM Apocalypse did, like, in a way served like both of those purposes. The main discovery was for all the people watching who had no idea there was ever even a real-time XCOM game, and seeing what that bullshit was like. But there was also an element of discovery for me because I had never beaten that game as a kid, and I was finally able to discover the admittedly terrible endgame to that. So, Faria, yes. Faria is a perfect example, funny enough. Faria was very much a discovery process for all of us, because in the end, it was actually kind of, it was a terrible game, but it was a neat terrible game. And we all learned something from that. Yeah, Faria was wild. That's the kind of stuff. I'm gonna get out my notes. I'm gonna check my notes. Yeah, Faria definitely influenced this direction. Community Nights. The stuff that y'all have picked for Community Nights has also been a big influence on this. Namely, Gothic, Arx Fatalis, and Crusader. Those three Community Nights were extremely popular. Y'all really enjoyed those games. And I honestly regret a bit not pursuing those games further. The plot really went places. How was Stalker? Stalker was also good. Stalker is also one that would fall into that category. Other stuff that I was thinking about for this, Realms of the Haunting was a really good time and was a huge discovery for a lot of us. Penumbra, Legacy of Kain, Echo Knight. These were all games that I was thinking about when I was like, do I really want to do this? Do I really want to focus on retro games? And then I thought about the experience of streaming those, and I was like, yeah, that's what I want to be doing. What's up, Library Man? Happy Friday, Library Man. You missed the announcement proper, but I've decided to specialize the channel. I'm going to be focusing on weird old retro games from now on. And you've actually come in the middle. I think my current ramblings are supposed to be explaining what exactly this means, and I got a little far afield. Why? Well, there's a lot of reasons, actually. Because you love them the most. That's the chief reason. That is the chief reason. Back in December, did I run out of music? Yeah, continue watching, asshole Twitch. yeah. When I was pondering the question of specialization back last winter, it was between indie games and retro games, because those are the two things I like doing the most. Those are the two things that I enjoy doing the most. And then over the course of 2022, I've discovered that people who come to this channel as a whole, like in terms of the metrics, enjoy watching retro stuff more. More people come out for it, more people stick around for it, more people talk about it. And that makes it an even more fun experience for me when I'm getting more of that feedback from chat. It's like a positive feedback loop. So those are the two big factors that influence this. One, it is my favorite thing to do. I've said a bunch of times, power hours are probably the most fun streams that I do. And that's exactly what the appeal of them is finding weird old games like Bioforce Ape and Monster in My Pocket and Faria to play. You know, I love doing that. Y'all love doing that. So it made it a much easier decision to do that. I'm glad you played Steridan before this announcement, because now it doesn't matter. No, that's not true either. So yeah, let me hurry up and assuage some fears here, because I keep getting sidetracked and not explaining what exactly this means for the channel. So let's go through it. Power hours are not changing, because power hours are basically the epitome of this direction. Fridays are not actually changing. I want to keep Fridays as wide open variety nights so that I can do whatever the hell I want on these nights. It's good. I like having the freedom of having one night a week where it doesn't matter, and I can just do whatever I want. And with that in mind, Fridays are nights where I can still do first looks at indie games, because that's what's popular about them. And that was another factor in this decision. As much as I love indie games, I do genuinely love playing indie games and experiencing indie games and discovering indie games. Full playthroughs of indie games suffer horribly on this channel. And I have three examples of that. Paradise Killer, Chicory, and Spiritfarer are three games that I absolutely fucking love, and they performed horribly as full playthroughs. So that was honestly another big factor in this decision, because as much as I like playing indie games for my channel at this time only really work for first look. I can only do them for one night or part of one night. You played all three when they were new? I mean, yeah. Yeah, but I mean, I don't know. Okay. Indie games on Twitch have a severe discoverability problem. People are only going to come out and watch an indie game when it's new. That's the only time it's going to attract new people. But at the same time, those new people that come in are just as likely to check back out when they're like, oh, this is a really cool game, I want to play it myself. So, why do you care about metrics at all, though? Who cares who is watching? I do. And there's a specific reason for that, Library Man. Like, I enjoy streams the most when I have people to talk to. You know, that's the part of streaming. That's where all the appeal of streaming comes from, is playing games with people and having people to talk to. And if I'm just like, who gives, I'm going to play whatever I want. Who cares what people watch? I'm not going to get as many people out. You know, I can tell you right now, if we're being completely honest here, when I'm playing something that's not so popular, that not many people come out to watch, and when there is a long lull in the chat, internally, I get very uncomfortable. I get a mix of chaotic emotions then. And I hate to admit it, but I felt that very much when I was playing Kirby. When I was playing the new Kirby game, which I loved, and which the people that came out to watch it loved, there were a couple nights where, like, chat just kind of died out, and I was like, oh god. So, and that is an experience that I want to avoid. So, this is getting the zone a lot of respect or reaction. This should above all be good for you. And you're like, yeah. So, again, I said this like, you know, 40 minutes ago, so folks might have missed this. I will never do anything with this channel that will make it less fun for me. I am never going to compromise my enjoyment of streaming for channel growth or clout or sponsor, whatever. Like, the reason I do this is because it's important to me. Because it's important to my happiness and my mental health, and I know it's important to all of y'all as well. So the enjoyment of this is something that I will never compromise, ever. What I'm doing by specializing in weird old games is I am focusing my enjoyment on something that I enjoy the most, and in a way that I think will benefit the channel, that I think will help with growth. And I'm just, you know, I'm basing that on the, specifically the last couple of weeks when we've been playing stuff like XCOM and Syndicate, and numbers have been going up, and I've seen a lot of new people in chat, and they seem very engaged and interested in what I'm doing, and I like that. That's exciting. It is very exciting to see new people come out, and it is 10 times more exciting when they come back the next night. And it's like, oh, dude, that's cool. So I'm doing what I can to foster growth and retention by doing the things that I enjoy the most, which to me sounds like a perfect dovetailing of concerns here. I believe by doing this, I can improve the quality of the channel and have more fun doing what I do. Newhauser figured it out. I was calling him out. Lively chat that isn't spam fest is the most fun part. I gotta say, I'm I really think, I don't mean to keep shaking the desk, but I like resting. I like having something to do with my hands. I like resting here, and then my whole setup is so fragile that it's like I'm having an earthquake constantly. All right, serious chat for a second here. Y'all are special. This community, this channel that we have is very, very special. Because I tour around Twitch every now and then. I check out small channels, I check out big channels. I like to see what they're doing. I like to see how they handle common issues of streamers and stuff. And I have noticed, I have seen so many channels with like hundreds of viewers where chat is not as active as ours is. And it kind of blows my mind. I don't even understand how that worked. I genuinely don't understand. I'm not trying to throw shade on anybody. I'm not trying to disparage any larger streamers or their chats or anything. I'm just saying, like, I don't understand how a channel gets so big and then there's not the chat is so inactive. Sometimes resolve. No, this is a consistent thing. This is some of the channels that I watch sometimes. This is a consistent thing. 100, 200 viewers and very, very slow chat. No, I'm not naming names. I'm not burning any bridges. Yes, I hate big streamers. Death to all big streamers. I'll be the one manning the guillotine. Market for having something relaxing on in the background. Yeah, I suppose that is true, yeah. Engage with chat more than many others do too. I've noticed that too, yeah. I have noticed that. Which also kind of surprised. It was, because that was always the thing that appealed to me about streaming, was just having a crowd of people to talk to hang out with, you know? I've said it so many times that like, I want, When I was in school, when I was in high school and college, my favorite memories were sitting around in the lounge where one person is playing a game, like Silent Hill or Mario or whatever, and the rest of us are just hanging out talking about it. And that's the feeling that I want to capture with my stream, where we're just hanging out. I'm playing the game, but we're all talking about it, you know, or whatever is going on at the time. And yeah, I mean, it makes sense that other streamers would have different, you know, different intents, different concepts for their channel. But yeah, it's just, I don't know. Chat is such a valuable thing. Chat is such an elemental part of the experience for me. It's just weird. We don't have to pay you to chat with us. To me, being a Twitch streamer doesn't interact with chat as being a stand-up comedian and doesn't want the audience to react. Didn't have a LAN. I used to do LAN parties. I did LAN parties in like middle school. We did like Quake 1 and Tribes and StarCraft LAN parties. And then when I was in, it was mainly in college. I would go over to my friend's house. They had a great gaming setup with a whole bunch of emulators and stuff connected to their TV. And we would just sit down. One person would take the controller. They'd just start playing random Nintendo or Super Nintendo games. And we would just sit around and talk. You know, honestly, I don't think I ever really made this connection. That might have been the genesis of the Power Hour. That might have subconsciously been how I came up with the Power Hours. Because I wanted to go back to that specific experience of just playing random old console games and talking about them, and doing it through the medium of the magazine was like the perfect way to kick that off. So, actually, yeah. Didn't really think about that, but I guess that's how that happened. You ever think of collabing with some of the people we raid frequently? I've thought about it. I guess I should mention this too. This is a little off topic, but I mean, we're just chatting tonight, so what the hell ever. We haven't done any multiplayer nights in a long time. And the truth of the matter is, I'm really comfortable with the way that I stream, and doing something like multiplayer or collaboration kind of pulls me out of that comfort zone. Stats are lower on multiplayer nights. I'm not so concerned about that, because the people who are involved in the multiplayer night obviously are having like a really good time and like making connections and stuff like that. But yeah, it's because I ruined his last one. No. Just thinking back, when we do a multiplayer, I'm thinking about like when we did like Viscera Cleanup, or Golf with Your Friends, or Phasmophobia. When I'm doing a multiplayer night like that, I am chatting with the other people in the game, and I'm mainly conversing with them and talking with them. And when I do that, I lose out on chat. Is the thing. And I enjoy those multiplayer nights, but at the same time, I always feel a little down after them, because I've missed out on that experience with chat. I just don't like when someone else takes the spotlight. What's up, Depressed Cat? Been watching someone play La Milana with a no backseating tag. It's hard not to notice how much it's killed his chat. Well, I understand you not wanting people to spoil the game for you. People need something to talk about, or it starts to get weird. That's an interesting point. I've tried not to ever be too stringent about spoilers. I think the worst I was about that was with Bloodborne, and people still found things to talk about. But I also wasn't very strict about it either. Not super strict. Multiplayer night, but everyone's mute. I mean, if we're being honest here, the last multiplayer night I did was Streets of Rogue, right? We didn't do voice chat for that. That was kind of perfect. That was kind of ideal. I don't want to make anybody feel bad. I don't want you to feel like I don't want to hang out with y'all and talk with y'all. I like doing that. It's just it becomes an either or thing. It becomes do I have my Smokey. It becomes an either or thing. Do we have this shared experience with chat, or do I have this shared experience with voice chat? And it always feels a little bad to me to have to choose, and inevitably choose voice chat, because that's who's there and doing stuff. Oh, that's true. That's true. We did set up a whole different channel to talk about Bloodborne. That is actually, Dominic, I'm glad you mentioned that. That is an important factor there. So there was the opportunity for people to get all that stuff out. So. He got upset with me accidentally shooting. But yeah, I think that's why I haven't done multiplayer stuff in a while, and that's why I haven't seriously considered doing any collab stuff. It's because I'm just really comfortable. I can't overstate how much of a comfort zone this streaming is. And it might be because I mentioned this to y'all before. I'm naturally an introvert. I get really awkward around people I don't know. I get really awkward. I used to get really awkward in front of cameras. I had when we were still doing voiceovers for my job. I would sometimes help direct voiceover stuff for the games I work on. And back when we used to go into the studio, there was one time where our company brought a camera crew to do like a behind the scenes thing. And for part of that, they wanted me to speak. They wanted me to talk about it. And so I talked with the guy, like, all right, here's what you should say, here's what you manage this stuff. And I sat down, and started the camera rolling, and I literally froze. I could not talk. And I was like, I'm sorry, just give me a second here. And I kind of like flushed my mind, and it was fine after that, but I am actually an introvert. My social batteries run down pretty fast. in some situations. And the pandemic has only made that worse. Spending so much time cloistered in my house and avoiding people, I think has exacerbated some of that. And yet, this is seriously like one of the most comfortable things I do. Talking to 30 odd people right now, talking into a camera to folks I've never met in person, but I know some of you, many of you, very well at this point. And yeah, I don't fully understand how that happened either. I don't really get how I can be such an awkward introvert in other parts of my life, and then come on here and be like, "Whoa, what's up, chat? Yeah, it's fucking Pleasant Fair. Yeah, ah!" I don't know how that happens. I really don't. We've seen the video of you dancing at E3. All right, they paid me to do that. Money is a powerful motivator. It's weirdly comforting. Weirdly, I don't know how. It's because you have power over us. distance makes it easier. Maybe. Help some of us have actually shit parts of our lives. You being you, and more for some of us. Well, I mean that's. I guess that is part of it. Yeah. Because I do, I do feel really good about what this channel has been for other folks too. I do feel a lot of gratification that I've been able to help people even in the smallest ways, just brightening somebody's day or distracting somebody from something. Like that's been, you know. That's been really big for me too, and I'm sure that helps with the comfort factor as well. I mean, you said they paid me to dance. I just pictured a really terrible striptease in the middle of a Konami booth. One of the songs in that I had to demo was like a techno geisha song where you literally it was a Kinect game, and I had to start kneeling on the ground, bowing, and then pretending to open a Japanese style door. I had to do that. So that was an experience. To me, it's similar to old punk shows I used to go play at. Probably more people in this chat than this shows really. This is serious talk, unless it's something like Fall Guys or something designed to allow a large number of viewers to play. Don't think viewer participant games works well for some channels. It might be best to just play multiplayer offline. We've done that too, actually. Not a lot, but we used to do it more often. But I remember I did the entire campaign of Quake 1 co-op with a bunch of y'all, and I had a fucking blast doing that. That was great. I think it was Dance Evolution. That's Konami, right? It was Konami's Kinect dance game. Stay up late specifically to see you and Mary when she's... Oh, thank you, Fury. I appreciate that. I keep forgetting I've only been here for just over a year. It feels like I've known people all along. I know what you mean, Eva. I know what you mean. Like, it's weird for me to think that I've been doing this for 4 years. Because it's been so long that a lot of stuff blends together. And it's kind of... I mean, if not for the sub badges, I would probably have absolutely no concept of how long some of y'all have been around. It's always interesting when people start piping up and they're like, "Oh yeah, I came in with like Dragon Quest Builders 2. I came in with Yakuza. And, you know, I came in at Risk of Rain 2 or something like that." I'm like, "Jesus Christ, that was like 3 years ago." Oh my god. Hexenez co-op, just saying. Even though I didn't know what the fuck I was doing, I never played Quake before. Yeah, that was really fun. That was really, really fun. Yeah, Manic, you were here for Dragon Quest Builders 2. That feels like ages ago. Yours was, oh my god, Resident Evil 2 Remake. Can't even place or remember where I found this place. Yeah, and then we've got folks like Newhouse, who came for Syndicate Wars. Last week, like, no, this week. That was this week. Jesus Christ, time has no meaning! I can't remember what week things happen on. Came in from your old roguelike service. Toast, I think that was year one, wasn't it? I think I was doing that my very first year, if I remember correctly. That's not, no, you didn't, did you really? Is that? Oh God, that is me. Jesus Christ, that really is me. Shut up, MD. That kneel was totally needed. Set the tone. Dragon Quest Builders 2 is no joke. The funniest playthrough I've ever seen. Really? Got Lojali and me from Dragon Quest Builders 2. Talk about Lucrative. First started speaking up during Undertale. I was lurking for a while beforehand. I don't even remember when Undertale was. I can't place that. I'm guessing that was year two. Curious US founder status here. I can look that up real quick. Wait, where was the... Oh God, I can't remember where that was. Is it here? Oh, it's this button. Okay. Sorry, hang on. They added this stuff. So we have, because I'm an affiliate, we have 10 founders. Most of them are not around anymore. There's been, you know, there's a constant cycle of folks. They, you know, people cycle in, people cycle out. And most of the founders are out. There are three that still come by fairly regularly. I know I got here for your reviews, not another channel. Yeah, quite a few people actually came from reviews as well. And that made more sense to me back when I was streaming the stuff that I was reviewing, and I was like, I was like cross-posting a lot of stuff on like Something Awful and stuff. A founder is one of the first people to subscribe to the channel. For affiliates, the first 10 people who subscribe to the channel get a special founder's badge, a first badge. If I ever do make it to partner, that gets expanded to 25. So you'd actually see some more crop up, probably. When you're playing the Surge 2 demo, I think I was the only person still jabbering in that hour. It was December. I was on a lot of drugs. That was a long time ago, too. Because that's when I was still pulling... that was still when I was pulling review copies of stuff. And I got that as a review copy. And they started hassling me to write a review of it because they were worried that I was just going to run with it. You cycle out those 7 or keep it for when they come back? I may drop the folks. There are two on here that I'm 99% sure will never come back. There are a couple others that are like, I'm not sure. We'll see. Month of daily themed reviews on Something Awful or How I Found You. Still took a while for me to realize you streamed and didn't just do text reviews. Yeah, Del Polo. I wish I could still do those. I wish I had the time to do those seasonal review series, but man, even before I started streaming, they were incredibly stressful. Because I mean, just like Spooktober is an example. Like playing 31 horror games to the point where I felt comfortable reviewing them and then write reviews for them, all within the month of October was. I loved it and I hated it at the same time. For that reason, Founders is a bit of a joke. I was like 30th on my friend's channel, who was already a fairly well-known streamer. Didn't hear about him getting partnered. Not a founder. Yeah. Yeah, I understand that. Yeah, I think a bunch of the folks... I'm sure a bunch of the early folks are here from Something Awful, because that's how I started it. I first started out publicizing heavily on Something Awful and like the Steam thread and being like, hey, if y'all enjoy my reviews, you want to see the stuff that I'm going to be reviewing, I'm going to stream some of it. Here's Graveyard Keeper and stuff. So. I remember how the last platform everywhere broke you. Yeah. Yeah. I can't do it anymore. I still like doing review series. Like, I had that whole thing with the Sirius Samathon where I was like, Jesus Christ, I didn't even realize how much I enjoyed doing a review series until I did that one. So it's something I'm gonna continue. I can't do them daily. It's a thing that kills me. Echo Far, holy shit, what's up, buddy? I'm here from Caves of Cud. Caves of Cud was a long time ago too. Ages ago, it would seem. Anyone ever get weird video audio desync? Yeah, I get that too sometimes when I'm watching stuff. I sometimes get my big audio thing on Twitch when I'm watching other channels is sometimes I get the music like weirdly pitching up or down, and I think it has something to do with like the upload getting interrupted or something. So, but refreshing usually fixes that too. Congrats on the new direction for the channel. I think it makes a lot of sense. Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. Yeah, I think it's gonna be more fun for everybody. I think it also covers a good enough cross section that it's not gonna. I don't think it's gonna alienate anybody. That was one of my concerns with specializing, especially going to like indie. If I was going to specialize in indie games, I feel like I would lose a fair number of people that really enjoyed the retro stuff. But retro covers such a wide, nebulous area that I think I can hang on to stuff that people are still going to enjoy. Like, you know. Well, actually, let's go back to that for a second, because I never did finish that thought. Where I was like trying to explain what this actually meant for the channel, and I get like one more day into it, and then I get sidetracked, which is fine, because we've got 3 hours to fill with announcement. Yes, examples would help. Good point. Okay, anyway, let me go back to what exactly this means. So, okay, I keep saying it. Power hours don't change. Focus. I wrote notes, and I'm not looking at them. They're over there. They're right there, and I'm not looking at them. Yeah, power hours remain unchanged. Fridays are going to remain unchanged. Fridays are still going to be variety nights, wild nights, wild card nights. They might be wild nights. The only thing that might change about Fridays is I might actually do more nights like last week's strategy selection, where if I've got a couple games that I'm thinking about for a full playthrough and I don't know which one to do, I might do like a selection night like that. The other thing about specializing is I've actually come up with some new stream concepts that I might try at some point, and they would probably go on Fridays. But I think the important thing, the really important thing for y'all is we will still look at indie games from time to time. If I get a hold of a new indie game that I think is really interesting, I will absolutely do a first look at that. I will probably still work through parts of my Steam backlog with weird indie games and like Curator Connect games and stuff. The wheel's not going away. The wheel is not going away. The wheel is not changing. We will still aim to do the wheel once a month, and it'll have all different themes. It won't be consigned to like weird old games or anything like that. Amor Helmet, community nights. Yeah, community nights are not changing. You will forever and always have a night to make me do whatever you want, and I am not going to restrict community nights to weird old games. Community nights can be whatever. Will you still keep up indie reviews? Yes, this is probably not going to affect my reviews in any way, because I guess the only thing it might do is you might see more reviews of old PC games in the future. Like my last review was XCOM Apocalypse. Because I tend to review the stuff that I stream, and if I'm focusing on weird old games, then I'm going to review more weird old games. But I'm also playing stuff in my own time. Like, as soon as I'm done with Hard Space Shipbreaker, I'm going to review that. So. Oh god, you're breaking out the death marks. I'm going to add a death every time you get sidetracked. That's fair. That's absolutely fair. So yeah, the special nights, wheels, community nights, those are not changing at all. Those are safe. Those are fine. So. The thing that is actually changing, the thing that this new direction is most important for, is the Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday full playthroughs. Those are almost always going to be weird old games that we think are worth playing all the way through, or at least attempting to play all the way through. Again, though, this is a direction. It is not a rule. And I have some examples here of exceptions that I will make to this. Chief among them, not all of our old games have to be weird. I am still intent, Lodrahi, pay attention. I am still intent on playing the Zelda series eventually. Okay? So I will play old games that are not weird. Sometimes, I guess some of the Zelda games are kind of weird. We should play Tingle. I know you will hold me to that. But yes, I am. We will get to Ocarina. I promise you. Lodrahi, I promise you I will stream Ocarina of Time eventually. XCOM is not weird, yeah. What about Golden Sun? Okay, so I'm actually going to look at my notes for this because I made a note about this. Okay, so again, the main focus here is discovery. The thing that I enjoy most, and I think the thing that appeals most to the folks watching, is discovering interesting experiences. Either me discovering a game that y'all tell me about that I've never played before, or me helping y'all discover something that you did not know about. So that's the thing that I mainly want to focus on with our Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday selection. Beyond that, our priorities of finding games, unique or strange is most important. I want to play stuff that's going to be really interesting and really different because I like having new experiences when I play games. And there's an infinite number of strange and unique experiences in the retro space. Like, infinite numbers of PC and console games that I've never played that might be really, really interesting. I mean, hell, last night, none of us were expecting the Addams Family on Super Nintendo to be what it was. I feel like that absolutely counts. That was a very unique experience. Finding a Kaizo-like game on the Super Nintendo. That was great, wasn't it? That was super cool. Ocarina of Time and Majora's are super dark, and I wish we'd get that dark back. What's up, Arcane? Glad this is not... Oh, no, it's not a sad announcement. It's we're focusing on what we seem to enjoy the most, which is weird old games. Romancing Saga Remaster is coming. I mean, the Saga games are this to a T. They are weird, and they are old, and I'm here for them. I am definitely going to continue trying to work my way through the Saga series, at least. Oh, this is so dramatic. We're changing all the channel, and not all nice to change, we make exceptions, we'll still play everything. We haven't actually gotten the announcement yet. I want to know how many documents the FBI found in the... Okay, so... Unique or strange is most important. Obscure is a plus. I think I think we tend to have a really good time when either I'm like, hey gang, look, it's XCOM Apocalypse. This game is really weird because it's the only real-time XCOM game. Or when y'all are like, hey, play Echo Knight. It's really weird and cool. Did you ever play the non-RTS Dune? I never played any Dune game. I've never played a Dune game, like ever. And then beyond that, old is better than new. Again, this is a direction. I want to focus on weird old games. Like, we're going to play a weird old game next week. However, every once in a while, I'm definitely going to be willing to break out of that mold and play games that are not weird or not old, or maybe possibly both, if there's a good reason for it. And I knew y'all were going to ask about Dark Souls. I do still intend to play through the Dark Souls series. And that is, I mean, you can make an argument for that being retro now, but that's not really a consideration. That's just something I want to do. And it's also an exception to the Twitch rule, because Souls games do really well. People show up for Souls games, that's it. So I don't need to worry about the metrics aspect of it anyway. We're not going to argue over what is and is not retro. I want to make this very clear, and this is part of this being a direction and not a rule. I am not making any rules about what retro is or isn't, because that would be dumb. There will be absolutely no consensus between anybody. I could pick two random people in chat, and there will be no consensus between those two people what retro means. We're not doing it. It is entirely relative and entirely subjective. So don't worry about that. I'm not gonna stretch. It's gonna be Eye of the Beholder here, which is coincidentally a retro game. It's gonna be up to me. Basically. So I will field any request. I will hear what you have to say. I will take suggestions, but ultimately I will decide what we're gonna do. And in general, we're gonna be focusing on weirder, older stuff. And that chat is the main reason I wanted to make this announcement, is because I wanted to set expectations. This is not a huge seismic shift for the channel. Like I said up front, this shouldn't come as a surprise to most people. This isn't a huge upset. We're not rebranding. We're not tearing up all the carpet and reupholstering everything. It really just affects our full playthroughs, and I mainly want to announce this so y'all understand what I'm looking at here. So that when I'm like, hey, what do we play next? And I don't get people saying, you know, like, oh, play, do a full playthrough of this indie game that just came out, you know? Dark Souls is two console generations old. Oh God. So yeah, I think that's about the size of the announcement. I think that mostly covers everything. I suggest Trio the Punch. Play Dragon's Dogma, all of you. Arcade exclusive. It's a free Portal game that's supposed to show off the Steam Deck. Oh, is it? Was that the... No, I'm probably thinking of something else. Oh, it was Death's Job. Okay, that was what I was thinking of. But I didn't have the gumption to actually say it, because I thought I was wrong. So, yeah. Be cool to say, we're gonna see the Death Job. There's my favorite Zelda game, Alundra for the PS1. Have you heard of this little known retro game called Half-Life? I would definitely consider a Half-Life retro. Not exactly weird, but never be afraid to be wrong. I'm wrong on stream all the time. I normally just don't think about it very much. Gloss past it. Well, it seems like people are already throwing out ideas, so we might as well segue into the other purpose of tonight. Now that I've made the announcement, now that you know that our channel direction is weird old games, let's talk about them. Let us start to build a base of weird old games to work from. So I actually want to make a list. Let's see. Let me get this set up. I am a list. That's right. I am a list. Okay, so I'm gonna go. Okay, this needs to go away. Bloop. And I think this can go away. And you can go away for now. Hang on. Doing some stuff. I should do this the other way. Hang on. I'm basically kitbashing a new layout together on the fly. Let me see here. Play every single game in chronological release order with only review ratings are between 50% and 70%. Del Polo, I've actually thought about doing something like that for like a Wheel Knight on, I think one of my concepts for Wheel Knight, I don't think we did this, but I wanted to do a Wheel Knight once where you could only submit games that had less than 50 reviews. Basically unknown games. Here we go. Okay, that works. Okay, so I have a list. I'm gonna make a list here. I wanna hear suggestions. I wanna hear thoughts for weird old games that we should play. How's an FPS RTS sound? Great. Especially if it's Battlezone. Have you ever heard of Uprising, Join or Die? Don't think Call of Duty accounts at all. And unfortunately it does. Yeah, there are. With this new direction, I think there are some things that I said I was gonna play or I was interested in playing that probably aren't gonna happen now. And I think Call of Duty is probably a casualty of that. So. But I mean, if we're specializing, that has to mean something, right? Alright, so I'm gonna just start writing down things that I see in chat here. Probably shouldn't have started with the hardest one to spell. How the fuck do you spell Messiah? Trio, the punch. Wheel Knight of mixed rating game. Oh, that's a thought too. Oh man, what if we did a Wheel Knight of only like mostly or overwhelmingly negative games, and people had to find the best out of that bunch. Freedom Force. Don't worry, like I'm looking for anything that fits under the weird old game banner. Not just PC games, console games are fine as well. They don't have to be stylistically similar to what we've been playing recently. What we play next week is gonna be a separate discussion after this. Magic of Sherazade. I remember we streamed that. And I talked about maybe doing a full play, because that game is weird. Oh, Garage, yeah. I've been keeping an eye on Garage since it got that re-release. MDK. Heart of Darkness. Uprising. Join or Die. Invest in and deploy units along with your own advancing, taking enemy bases. You know, there's actually been a number of like first-person FPS games. The two that I can think of are the Battlezone remake and Hostile Waters: Antius Rising. I have both of those. They're both really neat games in their own way. Did you know? Worst Elephant, Alone in the Dark is like, if I go back to the old request sheet, which I never threw away. I still have that. Alone in the Dark is one of this channel's oldest PC requests. Kingsfield, yeah. Kingsfield definitely fits the bill. Majesty, oh God. Oh God, chat's going too fast, oh God. Estatica, but it has spheroid nudity. Okay, we're definitely doing that then. Estatica. Whack, I played the shareware version of Wacky Wheels when I was a kid. That shit is so funny. Tale of the Sun. Sim Golf, okay. Sid Meier's Sim Golf. Metal Max. Drod series? Is that a acronym for something? Mousetrap on ColecoVision. Sanitarium. Sanitarium. I like Sanitarium a lot. I need to double check if there's anything that's a bit too much for this channel. Entomorph. Aconagua. Aconagua? Interesting. Adventure. Popeye. ColecoVision. Is Hostile Waters with Tom Baker? I remember that game had really good voice acting. Toho. I would genuinely like to do some Toho. Talk about RTS stuff in the Myth series. I have never played the Myth games. I think I played a demo of it a long time ago. I'll put Pitfall on there. I'm not promising you anything. Oh, well, actually, we're gonna play Pitfall when the, I guess, remake on the Super Nintendo shows up. God, that got ported to fucking everything. Shadow Tower is called From Software's weirdest game. Okay. Did we try that? We played some really weird early From game, didn't we? Valis... Oh, I remember that name, Endorphin. Strife. I'm just copy and pasting that. I ain't writing all that shit. Oh, hang on. Change the stream title. Great Greed. Oh, I think we're gonna hit that in the Power Hours, actually. I think Great Greed got a feature in the magazine. Might and Magic is a big series we could definitely get into. I refuse to comment on how I pronounce things anymore. Robot Odyssey. I can't wait to catch up to chat and y'all are like, no fucker, go back and pronounce that again, you piece of shit. Deadly Runes of Death. Broken Sword. Go play Games Dilemma, loves chat, gets less chat when gaming, has gaming channel. Life is so hard. Aconcagua. Okay, got it. Cool. We've never done Undying. Undying would be interesting. I wonder if I could even get through it. Odyssey, the Complete Adventure? Oh, that's not a typo? Okay. I've never heard of that in my life. Do Clive Barker's Jericho is much worse. It's bad. Jericho has one of the worst endings in any video game ever. You know, genuine suggesting fucking Atari games. Celeste. I told you, I will field any suggestion you have. Mainly what we're doing right now is this is like a temperature check for chat. I want to see if I say, give me some weird old games you want to see, where you're falling. Is it a lot of PC games? Is it a lot of console games? What era is it from? What style are they? So I'm gonna do some statistical magic on this to figure out what we're gonna do in the future. Kingdom Classic. I did that. Jungle Hunt. Really Strange. Oh, I know Pathways into Darkness. That was one of the first screenshot LPs I think I ever read. I would actually be interested in trying that, yeah. The Democracy series? Diablo is certainly a possibility. God, how far behind chat am I by now? Little Big Adventure. Evil Zone. Rhapsody. Look at what happened to Valis. You know no one talks about it. It's a Hentai Dojin game. Nice. Probably not gonna be doing that then. Ultima 4. Y'all are gonna start... Well, not start trolling me. You've kind of always trolled me. Oh yeah, Populous 3D is one I actually like. I think that's Populous the Beginning, if I remember correctly. Hyperdimension Neptunia. I'm just gonna outright veto that. Rogue. I know some of you have been after me to play Rogue for like forever. Derlangrisser. Heard that name before, I can't remember. Deadly Premonition. That's one of those games that I think I would only be able to get through with chat's help. I'm not particularly a fan of it. I think I got the Frankenstein game through the eyes of the monster. Wow, chat's moving this fast. Holy fuck. More ease games. You don't have any way of streaming GBA right now? Not unless I have the actual cartridge. I could pick up a GBA EverDrive, or, I mean, push come to shove, I do have software options now. So if people really, really, really want to see something that I don't have the hardware for, I can fill the gap. Should be able to get through Undying, gets you easier with spells inside. I've heard the end of Undying is really hard. Pain and Lynch. Aren't those the really gritty, like, co-op shooters? Pretty sure Odyssey the Complete Adventure is released before you were born. What's up, Shadows? How you doing? Maze Braid. God, I guess Braid was a long time ago. Deadly Premonition, only if he does most of the side. If I did Deadly Premonition, I would definitely do the side quest. Shadows, if you're coming in late, my big announcement was that I have decided to narrow the focus of the channel. I want us to focus on weird old games. I want this to be a more consistent retro channel, which mainly affects the Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday playthroughs. So right now, I'm taking open suggestions for stuff that you would like to see full playthroughs of. Hitman Original, Spyro, Nightmare Creatures, Bastion. God, is Bastion retro? Spore. I've always wanted to play Spore. Mist Marathon. I'm gonna have a really fun time classifying these and then figuring out what half of them fucking are. I'm copying and pasting that. I knew Wizardry was gonna come up at some point. It couldn't not. Demon Turf? Whirlo. GBA Castlevania. I mean, I'll put it on here just because you mentioned it, but we're definitely gonna do those. I almost did Harmony of Dissonance before I left for my Japan trip. Shining in the Darkness. I know y'all have wanted me to play that before. Pharaoh is a really hard word to spell. Reciteer? That's another one that I need y'all's help with, because I like that game and I can't get anywhere in it. Goemon Mother 3. This is a commitment these games are to your next review. Oh yeah, obviously, definitely. Suikoden. Did I spell that right? Yes. Aha! Is it? Kudu Kudu Kuduin? Is the game? Did I put Die by the Sword? I think I put Die by the Sword already. I'm not gonna be able to remember what I put. God, I feel like I whatever. I'll put it because I know it's good. Riviera, the Promise Land, GTA, not GAT, GTA 1, and I would love an excuse to stream GTA 2. I legit love that game. Shadow of Destiny. Doom RPG phone games. I want to play those. In fact, I should put games because there's two. Little Lily Princess. Fantasy Star 1. Salada Robot. I mean, I'll put it on here and I'll look it up. I'm gonna look up all these and see how I feel about them and probably make a short list out of this. Become an Atari Lynx streamer, play Kung Fu. Nox. Odd Brawler RPG thing where you play as a dog who pilots a mecha that grabs other mecha. Darklands, pray for success. Oh, yeah. I think I played a demo of that a long time ago and just got completely shellacked. I want to play Spore right up until they put limits on how often you can install it, even if you only had one install optional. I'll put Silent Hill on here. I kind of doubt I may do the original Silent Hill just because I personally enjoy it a lot, but it took me a long time to realize I'm not really a fan of Silent Hill. I'm specifically a fan of the first Silent Hill. Rise of the Triad. Original recipe. I played the Rise of the Triad remake, and I really liked the first episode, and then all the other episodes were terrible, fortunately. Bonk's Adventure. Headlander. I mean, whatever you throw out, I'm going to put on the list. If you give me something that's not retro, if it's not weird, it's not old, and it doesn't appeal to me on some primal level, probably not going to happen, but you're welcome to mention it, and I will look it up. And it does give me an indication of where your head's at in terms of games you want to see. So it still helps. You can't do Reseteer, you just set numbers. Eva, I have told you so many times. Nobody in my life has ever hired me because of my skill in numbers. God. Oh no! Oh no, I pushed a button and I became huge. Hide outside. R5 Delta. The Silver Pace. Somebody gifted me that, I think. I think I have that. Bomb Squad. What y'all are telling me is that we should have a ColecoVision night. That's what I'm hearing. Only one of the Doom RPGs have been ported to Windows. Well, we can at least play that one. Shadow of Destiny is exactly what you're looking for. It's stuck on PS2, PSP. Play some Saints Row. I'll put it on here. Saints Row 2 is supposed to be playable, isn't it? Space Invaders. Deception. That was another screenshot LP I read a long time ago. Darius series. Legacy of Kain, I'll put on here. We're definitely getting back to that. After all the fun we had with Blood Omen, I definitely want to go through that series. Maestro. Wasn't it Mad Maestro Arcane? Rent-A-Hero. Some of these games are weirder than others. I'm going to research all of these. I'm not going to go through this list and pick something for next week, mind you. This is going to be a long-term project. I'm collecting data from you all that I'm going to sort and research and organize to look for trends and common threads and stuff that I'm personally interested in doing. Possibly coming up with like themed nights or themed series like ColecoVision or whatever. Only if we should pronounce it correctly. Too bad. Where did I end? Hurdy-gurdy. Drug war. I actually played this. I went to a magnet school for science and mathematics. I absolutely had a TI-84. One of my friends got like a TI. It was like a T. I forget what it was even. It was like a TI-101. It looked like a tablet. It was huge. It had so many. It had like 100 buttons. It actually looked like a Steam Deck, but it was a calculator. I may just be defaulting to whatever I personally like that pops in my head at this point. That is valid. That is still valid data. Kingpin. Kingpin might be too gross for this channel, but I will consider it. Pirates, Legends of Black Cat. Kitty. Suggestion noted, Dave. Anachronox. Anachronox would just make us sad when we get to the cliffhanger ending and we realize there's never gonna be another one made. You'll survive, Dom. You've lived this long. Zaxxon for ColecoVision. Ace Combat 3. Electrosphere. The Anomaly series? Okay. It's not a disease, honestly. Wing Commander! Wing Commander would keep us very busy if we actually got into that. Mr. Mosquito. Man, I had so many chances when I was a... when I was a kid to buy Mr. Mosquito from bargain bins for like $5, and I never did. No one can stop Mr. Domino. Fucking Mr. Domino. Can't stop, won't stop. Witch's House, all right. Granny's Garden. Yeah, it is okay, Mad Maestro, cool. Chibi Robo. What is the feeling of pure text-based? Okay, pure text-based adventures. I think if we can fit a text-based adventure into a single night, it is fine. And I am going off our experience with Open Sorcery and Open Sorcery C++ with that. Open Sorcery went over great. Open Sorcery C++ did not when we tried to do a full playthrough of it. Next week will just be honest working through the research on this list. I mean, you've given me 115 games so far and I still haven't caught up with chat. In fact, I don't think I'm gonna catch up with chat. At some point, I'm gonna have to cut you all off. Huldsept. I know someone who didn't want to go to Magnet School got sucked into it. Armored Core. Kingpin was the FPS, yes. I think a night of I Want to Be the Guy is manageable. I will set up a Telnet BBS emulator to play Trade Wars on if it comes to that. Holy shit. Echo Knight, certainly. Subspace. Oh my god, my roommate. My roommate, when I was living in Japan, was like the fucking king of subspace. He did subspace hockey. And he was the fucking Wayne Gretzky of subspace hockey. I still remember, I was watching him play, because it was fascinating to watch. I remember he was in the middle of a game, like a league game, and somebody was talking shit to him, and he had the ball, and he took the time to type, "Get used to hearing this," like in the second before he made a goal. It was so fucking funny. He just wrecked people's shit in that. No one lives forever. Oh my god, I would love to do no one lives forever sometime. I wonder if I would have any trouble getting that running. The incredible machine. Nulf will not be hard to get a hold of. I have them. I own both of them. MechWarrior 3. Scenaries. Get the fan transition electrosphere for sure. Rebel Star on GBA. I'm gonna have to look up what all these things are on anyway, so I should probably mark that. Eternal Darkness. Clock Tower. We'll probably have to do Clock Tower at some point. Sigma Star Story. GBA. Shadow Heart Series. Space Rangers 2. BioWare Sonic RPG. Wow, an actual request for Adam Zombie Smasher. I was actually going to do that one Friday night because it's part of my original Spooktober series that I'm remastering. I guess I need to do it. Alright, y'all start wrapping these up because I've still got a ways to go, and I already have a list of 130 some games to look up. So I think this will probably work as a good start. May also be because C++ is very different, much longer game, not as clear with options. That's true. That is definitely true. But still, I think if we were going to do text-only adventures, I would probably, just to be safe, want to keep them to a single night at first. And then, yeah, if they're super popular, expand outwards from there. Rangers 2. Glider Pro. Yeah, definitely more of a full adventure game. Martian Gothic. Mutant 3D. Hacker. Hockey. Atlantis Trial by Fire. It's an official Disney Atlantis FPS on the same engine as No One Lives Forever. That sounds really bizarre and cool. The Enders. Shadow of Destiny. Ares. Say that Odyssey, the Complete Adventure, is your favorite Apple II game. I've played a number of Apple IIe games, but never that one. Oh god, I think I actually caught up. Holy shit. Amazing. Martian Gothic with Last Apple Stream Tops. I'm just gonna put SMT, I know what that means. Dune PC 1992. Sonic Chronicles was that. Okay, hang on. Where was that? Illbleed. We have not done Illbleed before. Monster Rancher 2. Zombies 8. I did a chunk of Zombies 8. I got really far in Zombies 8 my neighbors one night where we just started playing it randomly. Lunacy, Saturn, Islands of Danger series. Raider. I know Mist is on there. Yeah. Dream web. Okay, holy shit, I caught up. We got about 150 games on here, so. Baroque on PS1. Okay, I'm gonna cut it there. 150 games. Okay, actually this is fine, because Wolfenstein 3D I can't do because it makes me nauseous, and Fire Striker will absolutely show up in the pages of Nintendo Power, so there is that. You've got that to look forward to at least. Okay, cool. This is a hell of a list. This is quite a lot. Yeah, no worries. Good luck, that's enough to keep you busy for quite a while. What's your favorite bad SNES game you had? What's my favorite bad SNES game I had? Hang on, let me take a look real quick. You guys, shut up. Probably, I would say my favorite bad SNES game was probably Plock. The colorful one with the guy with the Velcro limbs. I really liked that game for some reason. And I remember I think most of you were not around for this, but a million years ago, we did a fateful Super Nintendo night where I played Plock, Bob, and Bubsy, all in the same evening. Smart ball for you. Plock does have a really good OST, that's true. Devin SNES, I Genesis, my favorite bad game is Cool Spot. With Mousetrap, you need the Coleco version. Atari lacks some of the utility Coleco had. I expect you have this complete by next Friday. Plock has his own comic now. There's their classic retro game Bubsy. Oh, missed your chance. Too bad. So sad. Oh well. Womp womp. Anyway, this is the reason I had God Galaxy open all night. Was I was thinking, in case y'all didn't have, you know, 150 game recommendations waiting in the wings, that we could go take a peek around GOG and see what kind of stuff they had. Bob did suck, yeah. Bob absolutely did suck. But clearly my concerns were unfounded. The Coleco can't emulate the sound box is not worth playing without the heavily digitized voice rambling and mocking you. Shit, forgot Jagged Alliance 2. Yeah, so I think it may behoove us at some point to do a more refined or more focused list using something like GOG or even Steam for ideas. I think I broke Dom. I don't think it's quite bad. I like the fact that Draken had a sequel. I actually would like to stream the original Draken. I don't have any idea where I can get it. I don't have it. I'm sure I can find it some. It's not on GOG, is it? Is it? Colin Co. Can I search? Oh Christ, can I actually search the store for? No, they have dragons. Dragon sphere. Why have a sphere of dragons? I don't understand. Draken had a sequel and the sequel is playable. How the fuck? Draken is also technically playable. It's really interesting though, because it's like an open world third person adventure game where you fly around in a fucking dragon. It's cool. Can't search the store from the client. It's stupid. Just use the web. Fuck. Fine. Let me bring up Dog. Dog me. Dog me with a spoon. How do we not nominate Panzer Dragoon? God damn it. Oh, there it is. It's $2. It's literally $2. This is not what I'm thinking of. We are talking about different things. Wait a second. Wait. Is that it? Hang on. No, that's not it either. What the fuck is that game called? Oh my god. Chat, help me out. Draken Guard? Okay, well it doesn't. Okay, it's not here. Let me. Draken Guard. Yeah. Come on. No, it's not Draken Guard either. Fuck, what is that game called? Shit. Okay. Wait. I don't have it, but I have the sequel that was on PS2. Let me find it. Let me peruse the library. This is gonna drive me insane until I find it. It's probably on the bottom of the stack too, because I didn't. It was so unfortunate. The PC version was really, really interesting, and the PS2 sequel wasn't. It kind of sucked. I kind of wonder how much some of these discs are worth now. Not that I would ever in a million years sell them, but I am kind of curious. YouTube, I will tell you when I have had enough. Not Jade Cocoon. Do y'all play this sometime? I know it's not a great game, but we could. Rented that as a kid, Okage. Took me fucking ages to find this. It's just okay. This is why I couldn't do this. It's Drakan. It's not Draken. It's Drakan. Yeah, Drakan the Ancient's Gate was the PS2 one that wasn't great. Order of the Flame. Order of the Flame is the one I'm thinking of. Here you go, chat. This is the game that I actually want to play. Draken D's nuts! Love that janky game. I want to play that janky game, damn it. Where can I get it? Who the hell? Developed by Surreal Software, published by Psygnosis. Psygnosis. Thank you.
hell would I find that? Origami, thing might be worth looking at sometime.
Do I have any other surprises in here? OG God of War, Dynasty Tactics. Oh, look! Here's my disc for Soul Reaver 2. Which, for the longest time, was the only Legacy of Kain game that I played. Twisted Metal to OG DMC. Of course, if I was gonna do this, I would just do the Steam port. Y'all remember Sly Cooper? Did anyone recommend Onimusha? No. Onimusha is something I would like to do of my own accord. Soul Reaver 2 is one part of a great game. Drakan seems to be Abandonware as far as I can see. Okay, I might grab that and see if I can get it running then. Because I would like to at least give that a try. I don't know if it's full playthrough worthy, but... By the way, this has to be in our near future. I am bound and determined to play this game. It is both weird and old, chat. It fits us like a glove. We already did Lament. We need to do Curse.
Okay. That's all locked down.
Curse of Darkness is a solid 8 out of 10 PS2 classic. It is a very interesting game. I legit like it. I like it quite a bit. Alright, I'm gonna test y'all. We're gonna see how many of y'all have been around for a while. Who remembers us doing this? You do? This was like, okay, so like, I'm gonna look this up. I'm actually gonna look up how long ago we did this. We used to do a thing with those. And I was gonna turn it into a series and I never did. Three years ago, we looked at this. Yeah, and then actually just 1 year ago? Well, somewhere between 1 and 2 years ago, we did this one. Yeah, if you remember the corn video, that was PlayStation Underground. What I never told y'all, at least I don't think I ever told y'all, I have another one of these. I picked up another one when I was considering doing a series of this. And then I never actually did that one, so. These were actually one of the earlier big hits on this channel. And I feel like I kind of dropped the ball by never doing the full series of them. So that may be something that we return to. Yeah. We've done a couple different kinds of demo discs, but the PlayStation Underground Nights were special. Here, if y'all are curious, if you'd like to relive the glory days of this, that's a link to our channel search. There's three... There's three videos for the PlayStation Underground 2.2 one. I think that's because it's back from the days when I had a really unstable internet connection. And then one video for 2.4. But yeah, that is... Yeah. Remember the days of Beard Oddish? That's a real throwback for this channel. That is way, way then. Yeah, that was at the old house. Oh, the old... I hate to tell you this. The host has only gotten older over time, as it turns out. Didn't one of the PlayStation Underground demo discs have a demo of Beautiful Joe 2 that reformatted your memory cards? Maybe? Maybe. I mean, I did 2.2 on my actual PS2 before it died. How old host? Old host fine. How old you? I remember Beard Oddish a few years ago and Beard Oddish a few weeks ago. I run the gamut. I have all the bases covered, really. Oh man, all right. I had forgotten about that. What other neat shit do I have hiding in this cabinet here? Okay, I have one drawer that I'm not gonna go rummaging through because it's just chock-a-block full of stuff. It's where all my instruction booklets and stuff are. Also my copy of Wizards and Warriors 3 in its rental case. Games I remember are mostly the ones I played a lot as a kid from demo disc. Don't want to see your... I'm sorry. Do you actually think I have physical porn? Do you really think I'm that much of a Luddite about my porn that I just have a cabinet full of it? Would you ever be able to play old Intellivision games? I don't know, would I? Is there an Intellivision emulator? Okay, fair point, Eva. Fair point. It'd be retro, and we know you're into that. Send niche retro. Oh god. The mustaches. The mustaches alone would send people into conniption fits. Bet those hustlers from the 90s would be worth something, right? Of course there's an Intellivision emulator. Then yeah, we could do it. We could absolutely do it. Certainly. Jumping Flash 2 bit. There's a Jumping Flash 2? There's an everything emulator? I mean, weren't we debating last night whether or not there was a Philips CDI emulator just based on interest level? I mean, I have to assume there is one. I'm not necessarily disputing you, but I just remember that conversation came up. Is it Jumping Flash 3 that only came out in Japan? Oh, shit. No functional Vita emulator and it's killing you? Oof. Called Robert Mundy. That's pretty awesome. That is pretty cool. AD&D Treasure of Tarmin is a retro game worth exploring. Maybe one of the first dungeon crawlers. It has its own website and everything. Holy fuck. I'm sorry. I'm fucking sorry. This is so... This website is best viewed with a screen resolution of 1024 by 768 or greater. What the fuck does this run on? For Windows. It's no longer functional because of a built-in 2020-01-01 date limit, y'all. The CDI emulator version 0.5.2 for Windows. You need a reasonably fast 2005 PC to get acceptable emulation performance. A Pentium 1.5 gigahertz is probably about minimal. I miss websites like that. You know what I miss, Del Polo? I miss web shrines and web rings. It was something magical in the early days of the internet to be like, I just played Final Fantasy VII. I want to look at Final Fantasy VII stuff. And you'd find, like, all kinds of weird character pages and fanfic and stuff. And the whole web ring thing was cool because, like, you'd go to one site and you'd be like, oh, neat shit. And then you could just go to the next one in the web ring and get related content. It was so cool. There's a weird old game for the NES called NES Star Wars. You should try that. I'm just thinking of real ultimate power suddenly. Thought I heard you couldn't emulate the Zelda CDI games. Maybe that's a solved problem. I feel like somebody has to have figured that out at some point. There's no way. There is no way people let those train wrecks just fade into history. Yeah, there you go. Someone redid them for Windows anyhow. So yeah, I mean, I feel like that's probably the only thing worth doing on the CDI, so we'd probably just go with that anyway. Remember going through old web rings for DBZ in a ska band called... I remember Real Big Fish. Sign my guest book. Oh my god. The little visitor ticker at the bottom of each page. Real Big Fish, now I play Samba de Amigo. Oh dude, webcomic web rings, yeah. You would be surprised, Worst Elephant. A shocking number of those webcomics that you read are either still going or like are properly archived and can still be read in their entirety. Genesis game I cannot remember the name of is side scroller where you play the skater dude with an orange bowl cut. Surfer dude? I can't help you because I was not a Genesis kid. I know the Sanix and that's about it. Found out something that shocked me to the core the other day. Dude, yes. I found that out, yeah. I had a moment a month or two ago where I was just, I had this curiosity about old webcomics that I used to read. And I went around and most of them were done. Most of them were finished in archive and stuff, but Mega Tokyo somehow is still going. And I was like, it's kind of hard to imagine anything more cringe than that, really. Ozzy and Millie Author Archived are working on a series. Oh, that's cool. That's really cool. Is it Comic Zone? No, it's Worst Tropical Theme. Actually, chat, before it gets too late, there's one more thing we need to accomplish tonight. And that is deciding what we're going to play next week. Because fuck if I'm going through that list of 150 games y'all shotgunned at me to pick something out to play next week. I have ideas. I would like to hear your thoughts on my ideas. So what I was thinking, mainly, roll a D150, duck forces, I vote chaos. Y'all always vote chaos. I was thinking Dungeon Keeper. Your ideas suck. Do my ideas instead. What if your idea was Dungeon Keeper? Megatoka's pulling into... What? What the fuck? More immersive sims. We'll get to them. Don't worry. What do y'all think about Dungeon Keeper? Okay, I've got a resounding sure. Were the people crazy enough to give that dude any money? Seems good. Another game to consider would be Jungle Hunt. Yeah, cool. Fuck off. We're not doing the mobile one. What the fuck is Jungle Hunt? Somebody. Oh my god. Oh my god, the art for this. Look at this shit. I feel like I would not feel comfortable streaming this unless I did like a proper cosplay of this guy. Like that's like the only way I would consent to actually do this. If I grew out the mustache and got the pith helmet and the all white jungle gear. Yeah, it wouldn't be that. I mean, all I'd really need is the pith helmet. Community night. Ha ha ha. Let me see if I can find. Okay. Let me find see if I can find a high res version of this box art. There's a couple versions of this guy. Oh, that's a good one. Hold up. I'll get the helmet, give me a P.O. box to ship it to. Oh, there we go. Okay, let's see. Halloween is Oddish is the Jungle Hunt art. Oh my god. Can't be downloaded securely. I throw caution to the wind when it comes to Jungle Hunt. Okay, hang on. Let me get this going here. Cause I got a couple things I need to change here. My god, it's beautiful. Chat, it's fucking beautiful. Look at this. Hang on. Oh my god. It's even more glorious at high res. Please buy fake buck teeth for the stream of this. Please don't play that until I'm watching. Block those guys on the right though. And just, yeah. There we go. Now it's perfect. Let's have an icon shortcut in the bottom left of the image for him to stare. Fixed it. Everything's fixed. All right, so Dungeon Keeper sound good? We'll do some Dungeon Keeper come the next week. I know nothing about it, like monsters and dungeons. In fact, I had this game called Monster Girl Island that came with a gaming PC I bought from a friend. You need to look up several box art iterations for oh shit on MSX, their actual gold. Dungeon Keeper is no Jungle Hunt. Okay. Just so we're on the same page here. Like, you're not this. Like this is what we're talking about here, okay? This is the Jungle Hunt that you love so much. I mean, this is gonna be like 10-15 minutes tops. I'm not doing a full playthrough of Jungle Keeper. Jungle Hunt, Jungle Keeper. I just said Jungle Keeper, fuck my life. You know, you could probably, hang on. Is there one of those play Jungle Hunt online right now? Of course there is. Fucking of course there is. You ask, and I provide, chat. there we go. All right. Is this like a straight up one button game or what? Don't like this. What the hell is wrong with you? Go further down on the rope to get a big swing. Timing is everything. I can't actually find another button other than space that does things. Oh, wait. Okay, now, here we go. Okay. So we're swimming with the alligators. The vines are swimming. Stop liking things! Oh wait, I'm gonna die. Okay. Now that is a sound effect. You have a knife, you have to breathe. Oh, I do have a knife. Still, I mean, let's just... Oh, okay. Alright, that's not so bad. Oh! Oh, okay. He ate me. Ooh. Haha! Back in the day we play and only accept killing every gator. Oh my god, okay. Sure. Ha ha! Ha ha! This is the best game I've ever seen. It gets difficult. I don't doubt it. I do not doubt it. Oh, I got crushed! Oh, I got killed. I'm not sure what you're supposed to do there. It got hard. Loser, get used to it. Oh, I fucked that up. All right, here we go again. How do you go? I can't seem to move on this. Oh my god, okay. Booyah! Booyah! The vine part definitely doesn't seem too bad. Aha! I'm mildly misread. Somebody find me a sound file for Very Good, because I can't. You provide me another sound file for it to replace the one I lost, and I'll put it back. On a related note, if y'all ever want me to add sounds to the alerts, just provide the sound file. I'm too lazy to go out and hunt stuff myself. It is kind of fun, yeah. I've definitely played worse, and on the NES, no less, so. Haha! Get stabbed. Alright. Do this. I don't think I can jump over that. Can I duck? Oh, I can duck. I'm so stupid. Scrolling in the section genuinely impresses you. It is actually pretty impressive for the Atari. The moment I figured out how to duck, the game was like, all right, never mind. Okay, here we go. Ah, oh, so close. Ha! I'm sorry, what the fuck was supposed to happen there? am I doing about this guy? Dying, apparently. Oh, okay, you don't beat him. You keep pushing against the edge of the screen and you leave. Is he Pitfall 2 and Atari? Because weirdly impressive too. I found a lady! Are you a nice lady or are you gonna kill me? I think that's a lady. Did I just beat the game? Wait, what the fuck? Did I just beat Jungle Cruise or whatever the fuck? On my first try? Buffering hell. This intense Atari action is too much for Twitch. The Atari game is just gonna loop and get harder forever. Okay, well, I could say that I beat it. Because I technically did, I guess. Alright, well, that was an experience. Cool. I think we learned something today, chat. We all... I beat level one! Hooray! I am validated to cross it off the list. And look, now we have this adorable scamp, and we'll do something about that. But. But yeah, neat, cool, okay. If you didn't see credits, Atari existed in the days before credits, okay? Oh my God, stop liking things. Stop. Look, I'm gonna put my face here. Any likes from this point forward are gonna go directly to me, okay? Stop liking things. You cheated the game and yourself. All right, chat. What? Oh my God. All right, y'all. Stop now. Shut up. No, I'm not. Shut up. God. All right, anyway, chat. 24 people in the chat don't like you. I'm gonna go through the viewer list later. I'm gonna make a new list. Yes, Dungeon Keeper. So we're gonna start Dungeon Keeper on Monday. I think that covers all the topics that I wanted to talk about tonight. I made my announcement. We made a giant, sprawling, oversized list of games to consider for the future. We decided what we're going to play next week. And I even got some bonus Jungle Hunt in, too. So, I guess it's AMA time. We still got like half an hour. Y'all want to hang out and ask me stuff? We're chatting. Crunchy or creamy? Absolutely creamy. I can't do crunchy. I hate it. What is your zodiac? Capricorn. Capricorn in the Western, wild boar in Chinese. I just post oh shit on MSX box in the Discord because yeah, you need to see this. Jif or Skippy? Jif. I never liked Skippy. Actually, now I eat We get creamy pre-mixed peanut butter from Trader Joe's. I used to get the unmixed stuff, but it's actual work to get the oil into the peanut butter. It drives me insane. Yeah, boar. Boar in the Chinese zodiac. Capricorn in the Western. Which style controller do you prefer, PS sticks or X? That's actually a good question. Um... I think at this point in my life, I've probably spent more time and am more comfortable. I don't know, actually. Because I use this now. And it's like, it's PlayStation positioning for the sticks, but they feel more like Xbox sticks than PlayStation ones. So I guess Xbox sticks position like PlayStation sticks is what I prefer. Chatting, it's awful late. See y'all. Yeah, Worse Elephant, thank you all. Thank you for coming out tonight. Thank you for joining me for this adventure. Who do you main in Smash? Peach or Wii Fitness Trainer? Are you pro or anti scub? I don't actually know what scub means. What do people say when they find out you're this spitting image of unky penny bits? What do people say when they find out you're the spitting image of that bougie fuck from Monopoly? They start rolling out the guillotine. And I have to book it out of there. What's heavier, a pound of lead or a pound of feathers? It depends on if the pound of feathers is still connected to the duck. Ducks is. What is going on here? Not a roguelike. My answer to that is this. This is all I have for you. This is all I can offer you in this trying time. How long did it take to collect all the posters in the background? Now, see, there's an actual interesting question. The majority of these are, let's see. Okay. Okay. Dragon Warrior 2, Dino Wars, Mega Man 3, Super C, Dracula's Curse, Solar Jetman, Final Fantasy. And Deja Vu down here were all from Nintendo Power. So I gathered them passively, while I was subscribed to Nintendo Power. Stuff like the Link to the Past map, Final Fantasy Legend, Secret of Mana, the, Chrono Trigger posters, everything else were, game pack-in. So I got those just from buying the games back in the big box days. So I didn't really seek out any of these posters. They just happened to me. So. Wow, attacked. Shots fired. Have you been to Australia? Why not? I have not. I have been to the United Kingdom. I have been to Spain. I have flown through Germany. I've been to Japan, I've been to China, I've been to Bali, I've been to Singapore, I've been to Canada. I think that's everything. I think. Is there any backstory to the username Gold-Plated Games? There is, actually. I'm so glad you asked. I think once a year, it's very rare, but I would say once a year, somebody asked me why Gold-Plated Game. And it is because my name is Audish, A-U-D-I-S-H. A-U is the chemical symbol for gold, and another name for a dish is a plate. You're almost there with Bali, just keep going. Have you ever seen the anime Kimi no Uzume? No, I have not. The majority of the anime I've seen in my life, I watched in the 90s and early aughts. So most of my anime knowledge is 20 years old at this point. Does your Twitch have any impact on your work? Do coworkers care or know that you stream? My coworkers know that I stream. Some of them have come out and watched now and then. It doesn't seem to be a big deal, but I don't think the higher ups know. So, and I don't play anything that would ever like compete or conflict with our game, so I don't think there's much of an issue with it. It's a hell of a show. Love everything by that director. Yeah, I don't think they would care. I mean, maybe if I got huge, they might care. But I mean, then they would probably just want me to run their streams. Because I mean, they do, my company does in-house streaming. When they do like big updates for their live service games, they'll have people in-house stream and talk about it, so. Can I redact some of my, you're safe, Library Man, don't worry. You're good. I do kind of wonder if my boss has ever watched any of my streams. I don't think she has. I feel like she would say something if she did. I feel like she'd have a lot to comment on if she did. They also made Ping Pong the animation to Tommy Galaxy hands off the Eizouken. Remember the sake of the stream, don't say. Nice try, Shadows. Nice try. I see what you did there. Oh, I had something I was going to say and it went out of my head. What was it? What the hell was it? Damn it. It was clever, incisive commentary on something. Yeah. Hate it when that happens. Oh, well. No thoughts. Only Jungle Hunt. Empty head. Full handlebar mustache. That's it, Oddish. You are fired. Well, nuts. I guess I'll just have to stream full time then. My wife wouldn't approve of that. All right, chat. Well, if you don't have, if there are no more pressing, intriguing questions, I think we might call it a little bit early tonight. I got a big weekend ahead of me. My girls are doing a cheerleading performance on Sunday, so tomorrow is a big practice day for them. Plus, they have their Japanese school starting up again. So you got for your clever story, I'll just say crapple. Thank you, I appreciate that. Oh, but that was absolutely true, Shadows. That was absolutely true. Anyway, chat, so just a reminder of the schedule. I mean, there's not much to remind you of in terms of schedule. Tomorrow night's the Power Hours. I think we're gonna play a little bit of WrestleMania and a lot of Smash TV. So if you're down for some Super Nintendo goodness and finishing the magazine and maybe some random crap after that, tomorrow night's your night. I'll be off on Sunday. Monday, we start Dungeon Keeper. The intent, much like with Syndicate Wars, is a full playthrough, but we'll see how it treats us. I feel with the whole weird old games, we need to keep an open mind about exactly how much fun we're having and if it's worth continuing a full playthrough of something. But I have high hopes. I really like Dungeon Keeper. I never beat it. Hopefully I have it in me to get through it. Go to school in Japan's big commute. Thank you. I'm glad there's been positive reception to my big announcement. I'm glad y'all seem excited or at least optimistic, cautiously, about what we're gonna be doing. I think it's gonna be a lot of fun. I think a renewed focus is going to provide us a lot of opportunity. I'm one of those people that I think restrictions can actually foster creativity. I think if you're just like, draw a picture, like the wealth of options, the infinite options before you can be kind of stifling. But if you're like, draw a picture of a vampiric Thomas the Tank Engine, you can get something really cool. Because there's a lot of ways to go with that, honestly. Looking forward to mostly more of the same. Just the full playthroughs, really. Look forward to seeing the reactions to some of the games I see. Oh yes, there's going to be, I think, a running commentary over the next couple weeks and months as I start researching and cataloging these games y'all requested, being like, I cannot fucking believe you put that on there. So, interesting discussion on how censorship of the 50s and 60s pushed creativity because people had come up with other ways to say certain things. Yeah, yeah. I think you get, you can get some really interesting inspiration and some really unexpected results when you put guidelines around things. Kind of like Jungle Hunt, can't believe you made me stream that. anyway, chat, let's go find somebody raid. A lot of euphemisms when you can't just say let's fuck. Alrighty there, let us go, huh. Slow Beef is up. That never happens. Slow Beef is playing Hades. Let's go hang out with Slow Beef. I like Slow Beef. Looks like he's still playing. Okay, good. Can't wait for you to see Heart of Darkness and go, this is so charming, and then seeing the first death and be like, why? Why? Thief series is a good example of it. I love the earlier games having lines like Taffer and the Euphemism. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. You get some really interesting creativity out of that. All right, chat. Well, thank you so much for coming out. Thank you for hearing my announcement and discussing my announcement with me and talking about games and enjoying some Jungle Hunt. I guess this is the first apropos of nothing, just chatting stream we've done, and I had a good time. I actually really enjoyed doing this tonight. I think that certainly opens the door for doing more in the future. If I have a topic, I'm not always gonna have something to announce, but yeah, we may very well do more of these in the future. And of course, we talked about lots of other kinds of streams to do. So. Anyway, thanks so much for coming out. Hopefully I'll see you tomorrow night for some good old fashioned Super Nintendoing. But until then, as always, you all take care. Bye, everybody.